from New York, it's Get Off My Lawn with Gavin McInnes.
You have to let that rug out from the oil down the desert way. Have been shaken to the top. The shaking drove his Cadillac. He went a cruising.
That was Rock the Casbah. Welcome. I am back. I understand Ryan did a show as me saying that I was back already. That was not true. That was him wearing a fake beard.
Yes.
And doing an imitation of me where it goes like this a lot. Apparently that's a thing that I do. That's one tiny facet of my multilingual personality.
I know this, Ryan. But Jordan Peterson doesn't always cry, but it's the best way to impersonate him.
And Trump doesn't always. No, the best Jordan Peterson is clean your room.
Yeah, but he doesn't always say that. He says a lot of things. But that's the thing that I got to, that was your hook.
I was listening to that North Korean chick on his show, as well as on Joe Rogan. And it's a great way to lose weight, listening to the Joe Rogan podcast with the North Korean girl. Because she talks about rats eating children's eyes. And my wife and I said, we're not having dinner tonight now. Anyway, that was yesterday. That was the last day of my vacation. I'm here now. And lot going on. I chose Rock the Casbah because that Joe Strummer's a rich kid and he's traveled all over the world and he knows other cultures and he knows when they suck. Iran sucks. And so this was like 82. Topperhead and the drummer wrote it, but Joe Strummer had a lot to do with it too. And it's basically saying that these fucking Iranian clerics, these Muslim clerics are shitty and fuck Iran. It's an anti-Muslim song. They've tried to whitewash it and say, no, we were just saying, we heard that you could get, you know, whipped if you had a disco record in Iran. And we were banned from Iran. We couldn't play there. So we were just saying, fuck this place. And I'm like, yeah, fuck this place now. Mick Jones has his face covered in this video for some weird reason. This was their only hit in America. Anyway, I chose that because, as you know, I'm not a big fan of Islam. And we are seeing them flourish now that we've left. There's ways to exit a country, Joe Biden. You first of all, you destroy your weapons. If it's too expensive to ship the Hummers home, blow them up, burn them, wreck them. But they didn't do that because Joe Biden is a retard. And he's obviously not running the show, but the people running the show are equally stupid. Susan Rice, that's who's running the show. Valerie Jarrett, who's behind the curtain? Whoever they are incompetent. And they've left Mr. Magoo, who, by the way, is getting thrown under the bus like Cuomo. Just like the rats eating those kids in North Korea, the left are cannibalizing each other, and the white males are the first to go. So they already killed Cuomo overnight. That was so fast. And now Joe Biden, his idea of leaving was just to get the troops out. That's it. So the troops have left, and the Taliban goes, not only am I going to take over all the land you spent, what, $800 billion in 20 years trying to procure. Not only am I going to go take it over, I'm going to take all your shit, too. So they are doing a real insurrection. Not an old lady wandering around, not guys taking selfies, not someone stealing a podium as a joke, but an actual takeover of the country, just like Iran in 79. And it will be just as bad for the residents there. But I don't care. I don't fucking care. You should care. They're going to get stronger, then they're going to come attack us. Okay, we'll deal with that. I have a feeling there'll be less American casualties than there have been in the past 20 years of being over there, up in their shitty fucking country. These are inbreds. The Taliban are inbred retards. And one of the conditions of inbreeding is you're a violent asshole. Who, like, just cuts a dog's ears off for fun. That's what they do. That's who they are. They take over a farm. They just shoot the animals. They'll shoot a donkey. Just for fun. They're, like, imagine, you know when you're a seven-year-old and there's that weird seven-year-old who, like, takes a frog and pins it to a tree with two knives and then he's whipping knives at the frog? And as a little kid, you sort of go, I got a weird vibe from that Donnie dude. Ours was named Steve. I won't say his last name. He might still be alive. But I remember him grabbing a garter snake. We used to always catch snakes in Canada. And he took the tongue, grabbed the tongue, Jesus. And pulled it out of the snake. Like,
Our bad one was
Evan. I was like six, and I remember going, that's a bad man.
Yeah.
That's the Taliban. What were you?
Our weird one would never do that. Evan, he wouldn't do that. He would just, like, do very mean things to people.
Oh. And then in high school, we had Clinton Badecki, who we broke into the gym. We were doing dumb things, like pulling the gymnastic mats under the basketball hoops. So then you could jump and do a flip off the basketball net onto the mat. And as we're laughing, doing silly, harmless things that only put our own lives in jeopardy, Clinton grabs the school stereo. This is in the 70s where there's like a stereo is a big deal. He picks it up and he goes, ah! And whips it off the stage onto the gym floor where it shatters into a million pieces. And that was, stereos were like really expensive that back then. If you, in your living room, you had your TV and your stereo. It was like your car. People broke into your house to steal your stereo. Your speakers alone were on a like a mortgage payment plan. So we went, what the fuck? And we ran out screaming. But let's look at why we lost. While the everyone, go to the next picture. While everyone is getting more and more savage, we are focused on this. Diversity, inclusion, white rage, critical race theory, slavery, Jim Crow, transgender, LGBT. Let's, instead of practicing fighting, let's work on our pronouns. I'm an isolationist. I've always wanted to get out of Afghanistan. I don't know why we were there. I'm very suspicious of why we're there. I suspect CIA and globalists benefiting from opium sales. I think it's about opium. It's about heroin. Somewhere, someone's getting very rich off of heroin sales. The military-industrial complex, of course, makes money from all the contractors, whatever, going down there, building all these stupid weapons. But I don't want it. However, there's ways that you can do this without total and utter chaos. And we have total and utter chaos. We have the worst president we've ever had. Jimmy Carter just stepped down. You're now in the number two spot of terrible. And there's probably some at the beginning, like that dude named Garfield, who loved lasagna and hated Mondays. Look at the class of people, though, that we're worrying about. Like, we're trying to bring these people democracy. They think you can jump on the side of a plane. What do planes go? I think they go 300 to 500 miles an hour. It's not a hot air balloon. Oh, I know. You're thinking of a bus or a truck. Yes. You'll notice garbage men, they hold on to the side of the garbage truck and they do just fine. I've never heard of a garbage man getting in an accident. They hold on tight. Planes are different. You see, if we have anyone in the Middle East watching, let me just tell you what a plane does. It goes slow at first, 10 miles an hour, but it very quickly accelerates to 100 miles an hour, and it starts to lift off. Then it climbs for, I think, about 35,000 feet. At that point, it's going a good, in order to get that thing to not crash, it has to go very, very fast. It has to whip through the air. Look at these inbred morons. Did some make it that high? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Like, wow. That's just animals. These are animals. Dogs would jump on the side of a plane. How? And by the way, no one sat me down and said, you can't hang on to the edge of a plane. Not once has anyone said that to me. I figured it out. All on my own. That's how smart I am. I sat there looking at a plane and went, I'm going to guess you can't hold on to the side of that.
You do some math first, maybe?
No, I didn't have to.
You didn't know math.
I just sat alone yeah. in an armchair and went, yeah, you're going to get blown off.
By the wind or something? Yeah.
It's going to be pretty windy.
That's pretty smart. I had to get out a paper and pen.
You mean you see those stuntmen? They strap themselves onto those little planes, right? True. That I assume go a fraction of the speed, and they're like, and they've got poles and steel and leather and belts and harnesses and goggles. They're not just like, gotcha. And another thing I've noticed about this shit show that is Kabul is they have a motto in this culture, and it's woman and children last. You'll notice it's 100% men. I've noticed this with refugees, too, when they go, they're just looking for a better place to live. And you're like, where are the women and children? These are all men of war-fighting age. I'm so weirded out by all the Americans there saying, our home was just ransacked and they slaughtered our dog and we can't get out. I'm like, yeah, what did you think? You're in Afghanistan. Like, you might as well be in South Africa saying, we're under siege. We don't know what to do. You're in South Africa. I mean, I understand people want to stay and fight for their country like they do in South Africa, but surely you know that the toxic ticking. Like that Die Antwoord song where they say, we see a police block and we just power through it because we know the cops will kill us. Look at that. Women and children last. Can I see your boarding pass, please, sir? Oh, sorry. That's too big for carry-on. You're going to have to check that. Like, I'm assuming there's not a lot of airport security going on here. Look, just run and get on a plane. What a nightmare. I mean, that's in a lot of horror movies. How many horror movies, sci-fi, action movies have you seen where it's a man and his family? It's zombie movies like that World War Z, and they're trying to get them on the boat. And it's they get separated from their fam. No, no. They're in a shitty, scary action movie. Go to 1-4. This is the insurrection. Insurrection is the order. Yeah, I love this. Twitter is so much better than the news. Like, the New York Post right now, the front page on their website is those dummies we just saw. I've seen those people hanging on the plane since yesterday. So Twitter is way faster. If you look closely, you can spot the difference. So there's the January 6th meandering, although I've heard that picture was from another day, but that's what the meandering looked like. Right? That's what it was. That's the threat. That's what what's her name? AOC has PTSD from. This is an insurrection. Like, Nancy got her desk back. No one's getting their desk back here. You're done. That's, look at my eyes. This is my desk now. I own this desk. Look at these fucking animals.
Hey, and nobody has their feet on that desk, though, to be fair.
Yeah, no feet on the desk. There's no humor in the Middle East whatsoever. Who's your favorite Taliban stand-up comedian?
Mitch Hedberg.
Mahmoud, Muhammad, Machen, Mahmoud, Muhammad, Muhammad.
I made up a Mitch Hedberg bit.
Although they did crack up. Did you see that interview that Vice had? Shoot, I forgot to put it in my notes. Where she says, and this, I can send it to you if you can't find it. This beautifully summarizes, it was on Showtime, the naivete of the West. She says, so as you move forward as the Taliban, this is, by the way, 3 days after Jen Psaki said, the Taliban's going to have to work out what they want their place to be in the modern world and how they want to be perceived. Yeah, they're really worried about how they're perceived. They're animals. This is like Genghis Khan. This is like the Crusades. These are just warrior, mongrel, pig, inbred lunatics who want to eat babies. Oh, yeah, here it is. Look at this. This sums it up.
Would that still include women's rights and a democracy? So would you believe in the democratic vote, though? So would people be allowed to vote in women politicians?
See, I guess they do have some sense of humor. Their jokes are us. We are the joke. We are the laughing stock. Would you have a trans leader, Taliban? I think I could get beheaded just for saying that. Hey, Taliban, would you ever have a trans leader? Yeah, this is not a meandering. Go to 1-5. Here we go. They're there to stay. And I don't care. I mean, it's sad. Trump would have had a much more effective way to leave. We wouldn't be leaving them weapons. They'd get some better dictator, maybe throw him in there, give him some guns, and say, blow up the Taliban with this, we're out. And we wouldn't see the same level of death and destruction, but I don't care. I don't care about the third world. go ahead. It's sad that Iran used to be like us in the 60s and 70s, and now they're like this, but I don't care about Iran.
Biden wanted to delay Trump's date for getting out of Afghanistan, but then he would have gotten the credit for it. So Biden said, oh, let's just push it back. And that delegitimized the Afghanistan government. So the Taliban used that to go to the different tribes and be like, look, they fucking, nobody respects the government. They fucking pushed the date back. They had an agreement. And Trump knows the East or the Asian world. And that means a lot. Like when you
all they care about is strength. Like when Saki says they have to see what their place is going to be. The Arab world, this includes Palestinians, everything. All they care about is strength, including admiring you for attacking them.
Right.
You blow up a base, they go, not bad. They're like boxers. You punch them in the face and they go, good punch. Oh, I've got a fight coming up, by the way.
No.
Yeah, I'm going to try to get into the seniors. I forget what it's called. It's called like the seniors commonwealth.
No.
I'll be the youngest guy there. So I'll just be fighting Santa Claus.
That is funny.
Praying that he didn't.
I don't know what's more shameful, having to be in a seniors boxing thing or being the youngest guy in the seniors boxing thing.
Like, hey, the two are not mutually exclusive. They're both very embarrassing. But I'm not fighting some fucking 20-year-old and getting pugilistic dementia.
Yeah. I'm giving somebody pugilistic dementia.
I'm hoping to cure his dementia.
Right.
I might like reset his hard drive. He might be like, I can recognize my kids all of a sudden. Thank you. 1-6 though. Not to say that there's no meandering going on. That's the beauty of taking over a palace. You can be violent, you sit at the desk forever, and you also fuck around. By the way, this shows how low their IQ is. Look at them. Look at this guy on this machine. Whoa, I'm going backwards. Hey! He doesn't even have his hands on the right thing. And just like the planes thing, no one taught me how to use those things. I didn't take a night course. I just figured it out.
That guy's going to hurt himself very badly with that barbell. He's going to throw it back
clown
pretty quick.
Look at his little pencil arms. This probably goes like this. They got that one right. This is, you probably hang on this or something. What do you do here?
That was my favorite part. This thing right here.
That one is your fave?
The one where he's
but
like
he's doing it right, isn't he? He's got a good amount of weight.
No, that guy's fine. This guy right here. Year. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's... I have to drink my eggs. That just reminded me.
Oh, yeah. You're getting swole.
I'm trying.
Is that because I threaten you so much? You're scared of me?
No. It's to defend you against any... I'm basically your bodyguard. If we're going out, if we go do something, I want to make sure my you're the cash cow. You're the...
But look, I don't look like me anymore. My hair is... On vacation, my hair and beard grew out.
I didn't recognize you.
I'm Santa's friend.
Santa's
Mark.
Understudy.
I'm Santa's Mark. Accountant. Yeah, I'm Santa's top investor.
So Santa, what you're going to want to do is you spend a lot of money on wood, and the elves, of course, you're going to raise their salary, but I think if you take back the wood, you look into carbon fiber, maybe some of the...
We don't pay the elves at all.
That sucks.
It's their culture.
This is pretty tough. Have you ever done this before?
Yeah, I remember doing that when I was a kid.
It doesn't suck that bad.
By kid, I mean your age.
But you just
it's fine. They just slither down. It's not like it's juicy. So you do swallow. Oh, a few gags there. Ugh. You like that chicken jizz? Ugh. You just ate chicken abortions.
It's just that it was cold. That was
you wouldn't believe how often in Costa Rica I saw a chicken cross the road.
Actually,
and it was doing it to get to the other side. And then my son, my eldest boy, goes, you know what that joke's really about? He knows he's going to get killed crossing the road. He's crossing to the other side like death. It's a suicide joke.
Whoa.
Okay.
Wait, that's a dope take, though. I made up a Mitch Hedberg. Did I tell you? You want to hear it?
No, yeah.
So I was, you know, talking to my friend. I was like, make up a Mitch Hedberg joke. He's like, that's pretty hard. And I was like, I got one. And I was on a bed, and I was like, so you cannot take the tag off of the mattress or you will get in trouble. Well, if you are trying to get me in trouble and you are looking at my bed, you are not invited in my room. And then it's like,
That's not terrible.
They took me to jail, and the mattress I was on had no tag. I think I know how the bed got there. Because it had no tag. And so if you have no tag, then you also go to
jail.
Way
too complicated. Mitch Hedberg has jokes that kids can enjoy. Yeah, like, a bed is a chair for when you're tired.
That's pretty true.
Bed is a long chair that's very wide.
It needs some trimming. If you are trying to get me in trouble by the condition of my bed, then you are not invited in my room. That's basically it. That should just be the end there.
What about like the first bed? The man who made the first bed slept in a lot. No, that's not good. What is a box spring? Why does a bed need to lie on a bed? No, why does a bed need to lie on a less comfortable bed?
Even a bed needs a bed.
A box spring is a bed for a bed.
A box spring is not whatever Paul Bazile used it for.
A pillow is a head bed. No, a pillow is just a bed for your head.
Hey.
Now I'm sounding black. For your head. Who is this clown, by the way?
I'm me. I'm you.
What?
I want to talk about my vacation.
No, I'm doing my news show. We're catching people up. Kabul has fallen.
You know how in the 50s, when you came, or the 60s, I don't know, the 80s, when you came back from a trip, you'd have a slideshow. Chikung, chikung. You'd have slides, and you'd show the neighbors your trip.
No.
I want to do that, because I was gone for a long time.
Okay, fine. Make it snappy, though.
Thank you.
No one wants to see vacation pics.
Hello, folks. I just got back from Costa Rica, and we usually go to Jamaica, but this time we decided Costa Rica. What's that fucking thing? Stop getting alerts.